We've been wondering, following Uvalde, following Buffalo, following countless other mass shootings around America that haven't gotten a lot of press coverage, will the federal government do anything? And the answer might be sort of. This weekend, the Senate came up with a framework for possible gun control legislation. They struck a bipartisan deal on a narrow set of gun safety measures with sufficient support to move through the evenly divided chamber. It is, of course, 50-50 with Vice President Kamala Harris breaking a tie. This agreement was put forth by 10 Republicans and 10 Democrats. It's already been endorsed by President Joe Biden and other top Democrats. And here is what it actually includes. Enhanced background checks to give authorities time to check the juvenile and mental health records of any prospective gun buyer under the age of 21. That is not, by the way, universal background checks. It's what I said it was. A provision that would, for the first time, extend to dating partners a prohibition on domestic abusers having guns. It would also provide funding for states to enact so-called red flag laws that allow authorities to temporarily confiscate guns from people deemed to be dangerous, as well as money for mental health resources and to bolster safety and mental health services at schools. And that's what it includes. You might be thinking of a lot of other things like, wait, well, when are you gonna say X or Y or no, we're just not going to. That's what's in it, Viviana. So there are things there. It is not nothing. What do you think of it?
It's a start. It's a start. Now, what typically has happened is they wanted to talk about, instead of preventative stuff, like let's take the AR-15s out. Let's stop giving those kids, let's stop giving those to 18-year-olds. Let's do that. No, we're not gonna do that. We're then gonna criminalize someone for not telling on someone getting a gun and then doing it like that. I don't know if that's the most effective way. It's something. I like that we're gonna focus on mental health. That is something that's really important. Is that the root cause of this? No. Could it help? It could. But if we're really gonna start preventing these atrocities from happening and preventing people who are not healthy or are in some sort of disturbed moment from accessing so easily an assault rifle, it's not like sneaking in a handgun where maybe you could kill a couple of people. I mean, we're talking about massive numbers. I mean, I still haven't even processed what's happened in the last few weeks because it's just, we're so numb to it now. I don't even know how to react anymore because it's so frustrating that we are sort of just like sitting ducks in this country and we're more concerned with the ability for someone to access whatever they want than the fact that we ourselves are sitting ducks. This is a real problem in the United States of how we have divorced ourselves from the collective. We're not part of the masses. We can't be a victim of this because we're individuals. But guess what? We are. We are part of the masses. We are part of the collective. It could be us at the supermarket. It could be our children at the school. We need to start really feeling personal about this, that we are the potential victims. And nobody likes to feel like a victim. But when we don't start targeting the actual weapon that is doing this damage, it's not, we're not confused of what gun it is. We're not, which gun is it? Oh, we don't know. We can't ban them all. We don't have to. We could just ban the AR-15. We could just stop giving that to people. We could take it away. No one needs it. The cops were afraid to go into the school, John. Why? Because they didn't have AR-15s. I mean, it's just mind-boggling. But this kid had it, had two, right? It's a start. It's a start. I'm glad there's a conversation. Can we hope for that?
Look, it's not like you cannot, let's assume that this goes into law. It's not like you can't come up with some situation in which this could stop a mass shooting. It is possible. So if the kid went to buy the AR-15 and had a demonstrated history of making threats or something like that, then maybe under these background checks, that would catch it. If they weren't in the system for those sorts of things, then the background check would happen and they can buy this weapon, which again, which this law does nothing to challenge, let alone actually ban. And again, we're gonna cruise through our once in 5 years chance to get gun control legislation without having a serious conversation about whether it makes sense for people to own weapons like this. I understand that if like all that you are as a person is a person who loves guns, then that might seem unacceptable to you. But as I always say, we draw the line where we think it is reasonable to draw. And if lots of people are buying these and committing horrible atrocities with them, that would be far more difficult to commit with weapons that were less deadly. Then we have to balance that against what you would consider to be the pros of them being available. And saying, I want to shoot feral hogs, to reasonable people, I don't think that that is a trade-off that we should make, that the parents of potential dead kids should have to make.
Exactly. And this is not a normal weapon. This is not a shotgun. This is not a normal weapon. Just like a semi truck is not a normal vehicle. And to drive a semi truck, you need special training and a special license. You want to own an AR-15? Fine. Go through a bunch of training, background check, make it extra. Like, because that's a concerning person that wants to own two AR-15s. I'm sorry. I'd be concerned. And anyone who's witnessing friends or family purchasing weaponry like this should be concerned, because what are you using that for? Even if you're just going to a gun range, I mean, that's probably the most scary place to go, because someone could just turn around.
Sure. And look, I'm sure that there's lots of people that have no intention of killing anyone who are just really, really into guns. I get it. I get it. And along the way, for it to be legal so that you can legally just go to the range or whatever and feel awesome while you shoot it, a natural consequence of that is some people who want to kill as many people as possible can get access to it very, very easily. They ain't that expensive. It doesn't take that hard to get them. And we don't require that you actually be trained or anything like that. So, you know, like I'm trying to think of, like, BS, I don't know what comparison to make, because there's no comparison to this. I was really into motorcycles in college and grad school. Okay, I never did anything illegal with my motorcycles. But if they frequently were used to kill hundreds of people, we would be having a different conversation as a society. That's what would be going on. It's only in this area where it is supposed to be, you are told that it is impossible to have that conversation, despite the fact that a majority of people think that these weapons should be banned. You are crazy and radical, despite the fact that you hold the majority position.
Most people agree that it should not be readily available to people. Now, if these politicians, they want to come up with legislation talking about mental health, that sounds great to me, but they don't mean it. This country has a horrendous track record when it comes to providing resources to the population. Now, my nephew is 12 years old. He's going through some stuff, as all 12-year-olds do. We've been trying to get him into counseling at school, months-long waiting list. This is what's going on across the country. People trying to access mental health services can't afford it, can't get in line, can't access it. Yeah. So we're gonna put the burden on that. Let's focus on mental health. They don't mean it. That's a lot of money. You know, it's a lot cheaper making it regulating the AR-15. That's a lot cheaper to do than providing mental health services for the whole country, which they're not gonna do. They're not gonna follow up with it. And then what they're gonna do is use it to punish doctors and therapists. Oh, you didn't tell us that he was crazy. Now it's their job to screen for gun control?
Yeah.
It's bonkers.
And by the way, like, I'm not, like, there's not even a conversation right now in this about raising the age, which is such a fundamentally different thing than banning the weapons entirely. We're just saying maybe don't make the people by far most likely to commit school shootings able to buy a weapon that makes it super easy to do a school shooting. And so, like, if you're a 35-year-old responsible gun owner who likes your AR-15, maybe consider being a vocal advocate for raising the age to 21, saying, I want people to be as responsible as I am, and I know the brain science, 18-year-olds aren't. They're not capable of it. As people are pointing out in the chat right now, and this is totally true, I can attest to this. Like, to ride a motorcycle above a certain engine size, you need certification. You need to either take a class, the MSF, or you need to be tested specifically for it, because we know that they're dangerous. And in that case, they're mostly dangerous for you, not for other people. But as a reasonable society, we require that you be tested for it, that we don't just take your word that you're a responsible motorcycle driver. You have to demonstrate it in a test. So if, you know, if a Kawasaki EX250 can require a certification, maybe the AR-15 can too. I don't think that I'm being a radical when I say that.
No, and that's what I say about semi trucks too. Like, because they are a danger. If you don't know how to properly drive a semi truck and you're having a heavy load and your brakes go out and you don't know what to do, you'll kill people. So you need a special license, you need special training. This is the same thing. Why is this such a big deal? Like, why can't we just Make sure they get training. Make sure they get back. How is that such a, how is that impinging on your right to own, you know, bear arms and to own an AR-15?
And just, why wouldn't responsible gun owners be?
Why would you be against it? Yeah, there's 100%. Children die, John. Children. Why? The cops were afraid. They're afraid to go in there. Why? Because this guy had this weapon. If he had, you know, a BB gun, it wouldn't have taken that long, maybe.
100%. Yeah. Yeah. And by the way, we're like 2 weeks out from Uvalde, and what has I think it's fair to say happened is what we said would happen. We had a moment, and now I don't know. The January 6th hearings are happening. So look, they're doing their agreement or whatever. But people are largely moving on because that's what's going to happen. That was the defense from the right. Just try to drag things out and then we move on. So to be clear, if you're just tuning in, what is not in the framework is a ban on semi-automatic weapons. It's not there. High capacity magazines. It's not there. Because if you read the Second Amendment, it specifically says that you should be able to pack as many bullets as you want to a magazine. They were very specific about that. No 21 minimum age to buy AR-15. Exactly. No universal background check. So none of that stuff. No safe storage rules at homes. No requiring background checks on internet sales or gun shows, which is like the most obvious loophole. They're not even plugging that. No banning family members purchasing weapons for their kids. Realistically, that would be very difficult to do. I mean, you could make it illegal so there could be penalties afterward, but it's difficult to know when someone buys the gun who they're going to give it to. At least that would be a filter. They make it in many states, you can't get an abortion unless your parents are okay with it, but they won't include the parents when it comes to the guns.
Well, they're only concerned about unborn children, John. That's a difference.
Exactly.
Once they're born, then yeah.
Yeah, they're fine with deborning the kids.
Only if you perform an abortion with an AR-15, then it's wrong.
Yeah, Jesus. And so also bear this in mind. So there are 10 Republicans that are willing to sign on to this. And so some of you contrarians might be like, well, John, you said there would be nothing. And there is this, and that's potentially true. I'm gonna give you some caveats. One, this is almost nothing. So I'm gonna defend myself in that way. Two, none of the 10 Republicans who signed on to the bill are up for re-election this year, and four are retiring. So even for this, it had to be like, oh God, there's gotta be at least 4 years for me to like, you know, get my like cred back with the right.
That's so sad.
And by the way, I want to be very clear. I think it's clear, but just in case, they didn't already vote and pass this. This is an agreement that they made. This loose agreement needs to be turned into legislation. And when that happens, there's any number of opportunities for one of the 10 to be like, I don't like the way that you worded that. In fact, 100%. I was trying to be reasonable. And you've gone too far, and so now it's fallen apart. And even then, the House would have to agree to it. I imagine at that point they would, even though the House legislation is much stronger. So maybe they would be turned off by the fact that this effectively does nothing. I don't know. There are a lot of steps still. That's what.
And there's a lot of potential travesties and tragedies that could happen between now and then.
Totally. Yeah. Maybe that'll put people's focus back on this.
It will.
You know, when the inevitable mass shootings happen. Anyway, I want to skip ahead to what Nina Turner had to say about this. She said the gun reform framework is inadequate. If they don't have the courage to put universal background checks in the bill, something that 88% of Americans support, it's a charade, not legislation. No courage. 100%. Most Republicans are fine with that. Most regular Republicans, not the elected Republicans. And the issue is that they probably rightly know that if they support this, then like an even wackier wacko will primary them next time. We live in a sick system, and this is one of the symptoms of it. Any final thoughts, Viviana?
I mean, we've regulated alcohol, we've regulated tobacco. This makes, you know, ATF, right? This is next in line. I don't know what is the holdup. It makes sense to do it. No one's taking away your guns, guys. We're just making it hard for people to plow into an elementary school and kill children and teachers. And kids that are, you know, not well shouldn't have guns like that. Yeah. It's just.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's gonna happen. And we're gonna do a show and we're gonna respond to some people being like, how could this have happened? And we're gonna remember, we as a country decided, no, we do think that if you are a potential mass shooter, you should be able to buy one of these guns. There should be nothing that stops you from doing that. It's totally cool, or it's just a necessary cost of a free society.
Well, they say we can't prevent it.
Classrooms get gunned down.
But we saw in Australia.
They say it and they act like it.
We can prevent it. We can prevent it. They have prevented it. They don't have these shootings anymore.
Yeah.
How many lives need to be lost? It's
mind-numbing. More. More need to be lost. And look, I'm going to close with this. I apologize, everyone, for the constant pessimism. I know that that's not the funnest thing to watch. And you know, I can see that a lot of other shows sort of force optimism that doesn't actually exist and isn't realistic.
We're here for the truth,
and that's
John.
More popular. Yeah, it's depressing. Like, I don't want to lie to you. Like, when good things happen and I say that they're good, hopefully you will know that they are actually good. I'll actually mean it in response to this. But and they it's something. It's
well, the good out of it is there is more attention on mental health. And if they are serious about providing services for mental health, great. Let's put the money where your mouth is and let's see it actually happen.
Yeah. Yeah. We'll see if the states actually allow it. The red states. They'll often hide behind concerns of mental health, but we know that, you know, Greg Abbott in Texas cut $200 million of funding towards that. So I don't think he really means it. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.